training for, but I hope it never happens.
Take a look.
I did some shopping. I guess it's obvious what I bought.
Take a risk. Take a ride.
I don't even know what to say about that.
Take the time to give. Give, give.
We're going to give you $25,000.
Ellen's best season yet takes fun to a whole new level. Laugh, dance, Ellen.
Weekdays at 3 on NBC.
We are San Diego.
NBC San Diego News at 7.
Good evening. Thanks for being with us. I'm Catherine Garcia.
I'm Mark Mullen. Welcome, everyone. Big news from the state capitol tonight. Governor Jerry Brown and Democrats say they have reached agreement on a budget to address California's remaining $9.6 billion deficit. The governor is abandoning plans to ask voters for a temporary extension of several expiring taxes. Instead, the spending plan relies on an expectation that the state will bring in an additional $4 billion in revenue in the upcoming fiscal year. The projection is based in part on higher than expected revenue figures from recent months. If those revenues do not materialize, the budget is designed to trigger mid-year cuts to education as well as social programs.
No, we're doing triggers because we want to have a credible budget here. And the triggers are about schools, about school days, they're about there's some other look. Well, you'll get briefed on it. I don't want to give you all the details. They're not cuts the Democrats like to make. I'll tell you that.
The governor also said that the new package would contain more cutbacks to the state courts and universities. A floor vote could come as early as tomorrow. We'll remind you that Democrats only need a simple majority, the new law says, to pass the budget, which means they do not need any GOP support.
Well, it was the talk of Twitter over the weekend. Tonight, the FBI could get involved in what is a federal crime. A security breach at the Grossmont Union High School District has compromised teacher information. NBC 7 San Diego's education reporter Rory Devine tells us what happened.
Sometime between 5:30 and 8:30 Friday night, someone hacked into one of the district's web servers. The information was put on a link and sent out through Twitter for anyone to access.
Sony's online network with its credit card numbers hacked, shut down, as was the website of the U.S. Central Intelligence Agency, allegedly by Lulzak, wanted cyber criminals. From Sony to the CIA to the Grossmont Union High School District, which was also hacked.
The information that they accessed is not very high value.
The district's deputy superintendent of business services says doubtful Lulzak was involved, despite people tweeting that all weekend. He says the district's auxiliary server was hacked and teachers' user IDs and passwords were released. That information gave people access to teacher websites set up to communicate with students. And people could get into teachers' emails if they knew how to get into that system as well.
Well, it would have enabled them to access district communications and whatever communications the teacher had elected to put on that email. They could have theoretically sent out a malicious email from that account, theoretically.
But no social security numbers, no grades could be changed, no commercial value, and for that matter, no sensitive information about students. Still, a federal crime and a hassle, too.
I can tell you our whole information technology department was in over the entire weekend working all hours to remedy this situation. So it is a big hassle.
The district will send out letters to teachers who are on summer break to call into the district for new usernames and passwords. I'm Rory Devine, NBC 7 San Diego.
The Supreme Court handed down a big victory today to an Escondido Indian tribe. The Rincon Band of Luisino Mission Indians had challenged California's bid to charge casinos in exchange for allowing them to add more slot machines. Without explaining why, the court declined to hear an appeal of an earlier ruling that declared the state's plan illegal. Gaming tribes had claimed the push by former Governor Schwarzenegger amounted to an illegal tax. The state of California apparently went too far when it tried to ban the sale of violent and graphic video games to minors, so says the U.S. Supreme Court.
In issuing its last ruling of the current session, the high court found that states do not have a right to limit what a child may hear, even if it's objectionable. Brian Moore has the story.
The U.S. Supreme Court shot down a California law aimed at keeping violent and graphic video games out of the hands of kids. Justice Antonin Scalia, writing for the 7-2 majority, said states can protect children from harm, but not from ideas covered under the First Amendment.
What California was trying to say in this case was that video games should be treated differently than other forms of media, and that if you have objectionable content, content that's not necessarily obscene, but just objectionable, you can restrict its sale to different audiences, in this case, minors.
It is a huge win for an $18 billion industry, which now enjoys the same free speech protection as books, movies, and other forms of entertainment.
This really is an important case. It means that children's constitutional rights are recognized, and it recognizes that retailers are doing a fine job of working with parents.
California lawmakers tried to restrict the sale and rental of games like the immensely popular and graphic Grand Theft Auto.
These ultra-violent video games can now, in fact, be in the hands of our children.
But the court found no compelling proof video game violence spills off the screen and into society. Parents groups are disappointed.
Essentially, what the Supreme Court has done is strip the parental authority from the parents of California and has enabled children to buy adult-oriented video games directly.
Supporters of the law say this game isn't over, and they'll try to craft another ban that passes the constitutional test. The two dissenting justices, Thomas and Breyer, left the door open to a new law. They noted that free speech doesn't necessarily include the right to speak directly to minors. At the Supreme Court, Brian Moore, NBC News, Washington.
Well, Gil Cabrera, a local civil and business litigator, is here to talk a little bit more about this. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
So explain, how is a video game, it's protected speech, I guess, right?
It is. It's just like a book, a movie, any expression that we have out there about art, ideas, is generally considered protected speech. And so that really wasn't a dispute in this case.
I would imagine in a situation like this, you have tons of parents now who are wondering, can my kid go into a video game and buy absolutely anything that they want to?
It's going to be somewhat patchy right now. Some stores have voluntary rules in place that don't allow minors to go into stores, but there's no blanket rule now, so parents do have to be a bit more vigilant than usual.
And I wonder if the industry will end up sort of stepping up to the plate, because I think the motion picture industry decades ago realized that if they didn't police themselves, the government would step in to do so. And I mean, there are some ratings which some game makers will put, but I wonder if we'll see more vigilant or less by the people who actually make these games.
I suspect you'll probably see it be more like the motion picture industry, which, as you said, they saw this coming a long time ago. They didn't want the regulation, and so they did a very good self-regulation that they've put in place, and now we're all familiar with the rating system. And so the game industry has something similar, and they at least signaled that they were willing to work with parents to sort of beef that up.
Whenever we cover these stories, it's often, you know, parents talking about how there's this link with violence, how they don't want their kids to turn out to be, you know, these awful citizens because they're playing a game like Grand Theft Auto. But the Supreme Court said that there is no link between the video games and between violence, right?
Yeah, I think most people would be surprised that despite the chance to make that link, the state of California and the legislature wasn't able to provide any evidence of such a link. There really aren't any studies that give you a direct causal link between violence on video games and harm to children.
Would that have mattered, do you think, in the long run with what happened to this case?
I think if there was some definitive study out there that said that there was some violence, that's what ultimately the court used to strike down the decision, and that is, once you're talking about free speech, the restrictions on it have to be limited and for really good reasons, mm-hmm. like harm to children.
Right.
So you have to be able to prove that it's actually causing harm, and the mm-hmm. state just couldn't do that here.
Legally, it's really interesting to watch. I mean, at the end of the day, whatever the U.S. Supreme Court decides or does not decide, it really is up to parents to also be policing whatever their kids are buying and watching, for that matter.
Absolutely. I mean, parental groups here wanted the help of the state to make it easier for them to do that. You know, we can't watch our children 24 hours a day despite our best efforts. But yeah, parents are going to be the front lines here in protecting their children in this regard.
Okay. Gil Cabrera, thanks very much. We're used to seeing you over the computer.
I know.
He has legs. Nice to see you.
It's good to be here.
Thanks very much for coming here.
Good to see you.
Appreciate it.
Mr.
Lago, huh?
Yep. There was a little bit of a development in that case today. We'll talk about 17 counts. 17 counts, I think, found guilty on. So we'll tell you the details on that.
Yep. Also, a new ruling in the Casey Anthony trial. Back with that. Look at this beautiful shot outside.
That's nice.
Isn't this great? Tomorrow's news tonight means not giving people rehashed information. It's what's important to our viewers. By the time people tune in at 11 o'clock, they not only can get informed, but they'll be prepared for the next day.
This is Last Night in the San Diego music scene.
I can't tell you that one.
San Diego Music, Sound Diego, only at NBCSanDiego.com.
San Diego's political dirty laundry since 1972.
I'm Billy Bush.
And I'm Kit Hoover.
If you're not watching Access Hollywood Live,
here's a taste of what you're missing.
Here we go.
Ooh, this is good.
Oh no, it's blinking. Run!
Blink! Bend it, Billy.
I'm bending.
We got a cutie in the house.
I'm such a fan of Access Hollywood Live.
It's my favorite.
Can we get some makeup for Billy on set, stat?
Daytime's outrageously fun talk show.
Well, you'll find the big news, everything pop culture, and us 5 days a week.
Love it. Live it.
Live.
Weekdays at 11 on NBC.
Gene Cubison, airing out San Diego's political dirty laundry since 1972.
A jury convicted former Illinois Governor Rob Blagojevich of nearly all of the corruption charges against him, including that he tried to sell or trade President Obama's old Senate seat. Here's Kurt Gregory.
After two trials and 24 total days of deliberation, the jury in former Illinois Governor Rod Blagojevich's corruption retrial convicted him on 17 of 20 counts.
Well, among the many lessons that I've learned from this whole experience is to try to speak a little bit less, so I'm going to keep my remarks kind of short. Patty and I obviously are very disappointed in the outcome. I frankly am stunned. There's not much left to say.
The jury found Blagojevich guilty of all 11 charges connected to what prosecutors say was his attempt to sell or trade President Obama's old Senate seat. News that some legal analysts expected.
I'm not surprised. The counts were significant, the details were significant, and the governor's explanations to the jury, I think, were not believable.
Jurors at Blagojevich's first trial came back deadlocked after 14 days of deliberation and agreed on just one of 24 counts. This time, Blagojevich testified for 7 days and denied wrongdoing. Prosecutors said he lied and that proof was on the FBI wiretaps.
I've got this thing, and it's golden, and I'm just not giving it up for nothing.
The message is, don't screw around with taxpayer money, or you're going to go to jail.
Judge James Zagel has ruled Blagojevich will not be allowed to travel outside Illinois without permission. A status hearing for sentencing has been set for August 1st. Kurt Gregory, NBC News.
Blagojevich had already faced up to 5 years in prison after jurors in his first trial convicted him of lying to the FBI. After today's verdict, he now faces up to 300 years in prison, but sentencing guidelines will likely reduce his jail time.
Well, Casey Anthony is competent and will continue to stand trial for her daughter's murder. The judge made that ruling after a weekend of psychological testing of Anthony requested by her defense team. As the case continued, the lead investigator returned to the stand. He was asked to clear up some earlier testimony where he misspoke about dates.
Are there any other incidents where you misspoke to this jury?
You're suggesting that I intentionally misinformed the jury, and I did not.
Sir, I'm not suggesting anything. I'm just asking you simply if there's any other information that you gave this jury that was false.
Not that I can recall. Is there something that you wanted to bring up?
I have nothing to do
with it. Wow. Meantime, in another motion, Anthony's attorneys asked the judge again to declare a mistrial and select a new jury.
A major blow today for Amanda Knox's appeal. She is an American student convicted of killing her roommate in Italy in 2007. Martin Fletcher reports a man convicted in the murder testified he believed that Knox and her ex-boyfriend did, in fact, kill the roommate.
Amanda Knox and her family were hoping for a big break in court today, but it didn't work out that way. They were hoping that the testimony last Sunday of Mario Alessi would be confirmed today by the man who has been convicted with Amanda Knox and her boyfriend of the murder of the British student. He had said last Sunday that Guido had told him that Amanda Knox was not present at the murder of the British student. Amanda Knox, of course, hoping he would confirm that in court today. She was very nervous, almost hyperventilating as she came into the court today for this critical day of evidence. In fact, what she heard was not what she'd hoped to hear. What Rudy Guerra in fact said is this, quoting from a letter. He said, "I will not stop fighting till the truth comes out, and that is that a splendid, marvelous girl, Meredith, was murdered by Raffaella Sollecito and Amanda Knox."
He had a chance now to speak some truth, and he didn't choose to do that. That's unfortunate that he didn't tell the truth.
Now, Amanda Knox was staring at him the whole time he was talking, and what she said when she had her turn to talk, "I am shocked at these declarations. He knows that we went there." Now, the next critical moment is when DNA evidence will be presented in about 4 weeks, hoping, Amanda Knox hopes, that that will show there was not enough DNA of her DNA on the murder weapon, the knife, to convict her. Now back to you.
Thousands of people in Los Alamos, New Mexico, have cleared out their homes because of a wildfire that's getting close. The fire spread to within a mile of Los Alamos National Laboratory, a nuclear weapons facility. It's been closed as a precaution. Administration at the nuclear lab said the radioactive material stored on its property, though, is safe from the flames. The fire started Sunday. It burned through 44,000 acres within just the day. Crews say the fire does have the potential to double or triple in size, and they just don't know which direction the 60-mile-an-hour winds may go.
Well, of course, as all of you know, anytime that there is the promise of a new drastic weight loss method, it gets a lot of press. Yep. But one we're going to talk about in just a moment is a new one even for us.
And drastic. Yeah. We'll be right back.
Rid of pimples fast, use just a dab of the Proactive Refining Mask, and your problems it start to vanish.
You are gonna love the Proactive Refining Mask. It helps clear stubborn pimples, plus it gives you that proactive glow.
The Refining Mask is my magic power tool. You just put a little dab on whatever spot is bugging you, and then you wake up in the morning and everything's changed.
The fast-acting refining mask is free when you order the Proactive 3-Step System. Women's Health Magazine says this Zit Zapper is no gimmick. The mask controls breakouts fast, while Proactive heals the acne and helps prevent future breakouts.
The refining mask is the bomb. Put it on, next morning, nothing.
Order Proactive for only $19.95, and you'll get the fast-acting refining mask plus the green tea moisturizer at no extra charge.
Proactive is unbelievable, and I saw results within literally 3 days.
Get control of your breakouts with Proactive. Call the number on your screen today.
Now I have fabulous skin.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. If you or a loved one was diagnosed with mesothelioma, call the number on your screen now. Mesothelioma and other asbestos-related diseases such as lung cancer have been directly linked to asbestos exposure. Exposure to asbestos in mills, shipyards, or in the heating, automotive, and construction industries may have put you at risk. If you or a loved one was diagnosed with mesothelioma, call the number on your screen now for a free legal consultation. Secondhand exposure to asbestos may have also put loved ones at risk for mesothelioma or lung cancer. If you've been diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer, please don't wait. Call today for your free legal consultation. You may be entitled to compensation. We're standing by to take your call in confidence.
Call 1-800-335-1065. Don't delay. That's 1-800-335-1065.
Maybe you've heard about this latest diet craze. It's called the HCG diet. And basically, it promises that you're going to lose a whole bunch of weight and not have to feel hungry along the way.
However, as Vicki Nguyen reports, there are still some questions about the strict 500-calorie per day eating plan and whether HCG injections, which is part of this program, really work.
prep myself real quick.
Nicole Andrade is injecting herself with HCG. It's a hormone produced by pregnant women. But this injection has nothing to do with fertility and everything to do with weight loss.
I've tried a million different diets and I was very unhealthy.
She's using the hormone in conjunction with a very strict 500 calorie a day diet to lose a lot of weight and fast.
In the first week, I lost 12 pounds. At 6 weeks, I lost about 26 pounds.
The results are dramatic, as the before and after pictures clearly show, but it's not cheap. It runs $900 for a 6-week program. Dr. John Tang, a cosmetic surgeon who treats Nicole, says HCG allows people to lose weight without feeling hungry, and it helps get rid of unwanted fat.
HCG allows the body to access this fat, this abnormal fat, into circulation, and allows the body to actually use this fat as a primary source.
Here's what a typical day on the diet looks like. A cup of black coffee for breakfast. For lunch, a chicken breast, some veggies, and some fruit. Dinner, ditto. That's 500 calories.
Anyone who goes on a 500 calorie a day diet is going to lose weight.
Lisa Richardson is a registered dietitian. She believes diet and exercise would have the same effect on weight loss without the injections.
They make the program no more effective than just the diet alone.
Dr. Tang says he also gives his patients vitamins and keeps them on the 500 calorie diet for just a limited time.
We recommend that people go only go for 6 weeks and no longer than that. So after 6 weeks, people will go through a maintenance phase.
HCG is not specifically approved for weight loss, but the FDA does allow doctors to prescribe it off-label. Dr. Tang says he has a 90% success rate for patients who follow his plan, a plan that includes limited exercise.
Crazy thinking to say, oh, just eat this minimal amount of food and don't exercise and you'll be better for it. No. I'm not buying it.
We'll help you.
But Nicole says she does feel better, and this diet was what she needed. Since October, she's lost 70 pounds.
What's great about this diet is I haven't gained any weight back.
It's enough to convince her the HCG diet may be a quick fix that has potential to stick.
Well, being thin may not always lead to a lower risk of heart disease and diabetes, turns out. Researchers in Boston studied the genes of 75,000 people and found that there was strong evidence that a certain gene is linked to low body fat sometimes. However, the gene was also linked to unhealthy levels of blood sugar and cholesterol. Experts say it comes down to the type of fat that a person might have. Lean individuals may have less fat under their skin, but more harmful fat surrounding their organs. A combination of calcium and vitamin D may decrease the chance of developing melanoma in high-risk women by more than half. That's according to researchers from Stanford University. People who previously had basal cell or squamous cell cancers developed 57% fewer melanomas than women with similar skin cancer histories when they took a daily dose of 1,000 milligrams of calcium and 400 international units of vitamin D. The women were followed for about 7 years. The study appears in the Journal of Clinical Oncology.
Transcendental meditation may help heart disease patients avoid major complications like heart attacks and strokes. More than 200 African-American men and women with narrowed heart arteries were included in this new research. Those who practiced stress-reducing meditation had nearly 50% lower rates of death, heart attack, and stroke compared to a control group of patients. Meditation was used as a complement, not a replacement for usual heart medications. The study is published in the Archives of Internal Medicine. Okay, if your preschooler cannot sleep, you may want to turn off the violent and the nighttime TV. This is the message from a new study that found sleep problems are more common in 3 to 5-year-olds who watch TV after 7 o'clock at night. Watching shows with violence, including kids' cartoons, also was tied to sleeping difficulties. The American Academy of Pediatrics recommends no TV for children 2 and younger, and no more than 2 hours daily for kids who are older than that. Okay. That means that my kids' TV should have been off 23 minutes ago.
I know. You know what, though? I mean, my kids were watching, like, a Looney Tunes something the other day, and there's all, you know, as you guys know, there's all the stuff that we watched when we were growing up.
It is violent.
And it really was violent. I was just like, whoa, you forget what it was like.
We were watching, too, this weekend. I don't know. Uh-huh. It must be in the air. And we realized that the Tom and Jerry is basically, like, an animated version of MTV movie Jackass. Watch it.
You know, okay.
You'll see. Watch.
All right. No, it's a good point.
They're hitting each other. And,
okay.
Anyway.
On the other side of the spectrum, not a jackass, is Fritz Coleman.
Oh.
He's a good guy.
Oh,
here you are.
Hello. What a great way to start the work week. Beautiful warm weather, real summer weather is here. We'll have one more day like it, and then we're going to cool off in the middle of the week. We'll get rescued before we get too crazy with these temperatures. Here's the high, making us warm and setting up an offshore flow so the coast is even going low to mid-70s. Here's a low that will dig south and sort of force a stronger onshore flow deep in the marine layer back up. You can see the offshore flow with the blue areas on the map where there isn't cloud cover. We'll get a little cooler Wednesday and Thursday, and then build the temperatures back up and end up next weekend right where we sit today. Pretty warm inland. Really normal temperatures. Cloudy overnight, patchy dense fog could happen. Maybe another fog advisory as we had this morning. Mostly sunny fairly quickly, especially inland tomorrow. Mid and upper 80 degree temperatures are possible. Wednesday and Thursday we cool it, and then Friday into the weekend, we build high pressure again and get warm. Mid and upper 50s to low 60s, these beautiful nights. You know, the low clouds and fog are not appearing until later on in the night, so these evening hours after these warm days are just to die for. Beautiful, beautiful stuff. Mid and upper 80s, maybe as warm as 86 at Alpine, 87 Escondido, 81 at Fallbrook, and there's the evidence of the offshore flow. 72 to 73 North County coast. I'll tell you, we're going to see some spectacular sunsets today and tomorrow. 85 Santee in El Cajon and 78 at Chula Vista. Your extended forecast shows, you see where tomorrow we're the same as today. We take this little dip on Wednesday and Thursday, just a few degrees at the coast and 4 or 5 degrees inland. Then we build some more high pressure. Look where the coast ends up on the weekend, just under 80 degrees. Of course, that means that inland we're really warm, 89, 90 degrees, maybe even 90 plus East County, but we're going to have a real summer weekend if it stays on track. The long-range computer models stay with their current opinion, and that is we're going to have a beautiful weekend after a little dip in temperatures toward the end of the week. So the mountains going from the low 80s into the mid-70s and then back up again, and the deserts, triple digits. Who's counting when you get that warm? Anyway, if you'd like more information, say you're planning your summer trip, go to weather.com or the Weather Channel for more information. Summer is here. Enjoy it. We'll see you next time.
Fritz Coleman, thank you very much. Caltrans reopened 4 new express lanes on Interstate 15 this morning. Phew, after 9 days. The area affected is that 8-mile stretch between the 56 and the 163. We spared no expense and pulled out our trusty map for you. The lanes are for buses, carpools, and fast-track patrons. Do we have an Etch-a-Sketch? There are also new entry and exit points. 2 lanes will now be open in both directions at all times, with the ability to open all 4 in one direction for special circumstances like a big accident or a big event.
Well, as we get closer to the 4th of July weekend, a lot of experts thought that we'd already be paying $5 a gallon for gas. You remember we were all talking about that. Well, it's turned out it's just the opposite. Prices fell 4 cents over the weekend. The consumer group Buchan says today's average is $3.82 a gallon. So when should you fill up your tank? Here's consumer Bob's gas price forecast. He says, let your gas gauge run near empty. Oh, my dad would not like that advice. The longer you wait, the less you'll pay, though. With the Saudis pumping more oil and the U.S. dipping into the strategic reserve, Bob is calling for prices to drop another 2 to 5 cents a gallon this week.
When do you fill up yours?
When do I?
Like when the light comes
when
on?
When the fume comes on and I can hear my dad's voice saying, that's not good for the car, don't do that. But I've only run out once.
Have you? I have a hybrid now, so you can kind of coast at least for a few blocks
and
you find something.
How green of you.
I got a deal. in just a moment, a pretty cool story about how new technology is helping autism patients. That and a lot more straight ahead.
The 11 o'clock news team, best team I've ever been on. Okay, that Charger team with Dan Fouts and Louis Kelcher, that was pretty good too.
I've lived in a whole bunch of cities, and this has always felt like home to me.
The best part about journalism is you get access to people, places, and events, and you get to share them with our viewers.
Whether it's local news, whether it's weather, sort of prepares you emotionally for the next day.
We are San Diego.
We are San Diego.
We are San Diego.
We are San Diego.
Deflated because that other daytime show is gone?
I've never been so happy!
Start living. Start laughing. Ellen, weekdays at 3.
San Diego Explained. Not just what's happening, but how and why. The story behind the story. We define, discover, and reveal. A groundbreaking partnership with the Voice of San Diego. So you can put it all together and truly understand. San Diego Explained with the Voice of San Diego. Every Wednesday night, exclusively on NBC 7 San Diego News at 6.
What is a typical day like at Access Hollywood?
Anything but typical.
Huge breaking story, let's move on this.
News happens fast, so everyone around here has to move even faster.
We are going to talk to Clooney.
Billy has the exclusive interview.
We know Hollywood like nobody else.
And we want to know what you think, too.
Let's get that up on AccessHollywood.com right away.
One thing that doesn't change?
It always gets crazy right before we roll.
3, 2, go.
No one does Hollywood like Access Hollywood.
Weeknights at 6:30 on NBC. NBC San Diego News at 7.
Welcome back, everyone. I'm Mark Mullen.
I'm Catherine Garcia. Okay, is somebody playing dirty pool in local politics? It depends on who you ask. Backers of a San Diego pension reform initiative say their petition gatherers are being harassed. Opponents say those gatherers are telling voters lies. Our political reporter, NBC 7 San Diego's Gene Cubison, says whatever political smack talk is being traded, the tension level at least does reflect what's an important issue.
Well, harassment may be in the eye of the beholder, and some say that's just what it is. Truth, as it pertains to all this, may be somewhat less subjective. Either way, both sides of the Comprehensive Pension Reform Initiative have grievances that won't quit.
So what does this petition do, though?
Well, like I said, talk to Jerry Sanders.
Not exactly a sales pitch the measure's backers might have encouraged when they hired a private detective to record two union members with signs as a signature gatherer worked a prospect they urged to educate himself. But here's the spin.
Being confronted by union goon squads and trying to imitate the citizens of San Diego is not something that I think that the citizens of San Diego are going to stand for. They ought to be incensed by it. They ought to walk right past the blockers, and it would be akin to, in some respects, crossing a picket line, if you will.
Just Say No San Diego, the union-backed opposition campaign, captured this sequence with a signature gatherer who completely misstated a key aspect of the measure.
Police and fire are exempt?
Right. They don't require policemen and firemen to pay into their pension. Regular city employees.
And the more deception that we found, we realized that, you know, somebody had to be there to provide a presence which told the truth.
A signature gatherer we spoke with says he doesn't try to explain the initiative to people. He just lets them see it, refers them to the website, and tries to keep things civil if he's confronted. But he knows of others who've had some pretty unpleasant experiences.
It's just sad, you know. But hey, like I told them, I mean, just keep your cool and everything's going to be fine. Just try and diffuse the situation as best you can, and it's going to work out.
Now, the measure already figures into the mayor's race. Carl DeMaio is for it. Bonnie DeManis and Nathan Fletcher want firefighters and lifeguards exempted. And Bob Filner says he has a much better alternative. Gene Cubison, NBC 7 San Diego.
DA Bonnie DeManis picked up another endorsement today in her bid to be San Diego's next mayor. Sheriff Bill Gore says she has the management skills and leadership to keep San Diego moving in the right direction. The two of them have worked together closely on major criminal cases over the past 8 years, including the prosecution of John Gardner, who of course raped and killed Chelsea King and Amber Dubois. DeManis has also been backed by Mayor Jerry Sanders, Councilman Kevin Faulkner, and Supervisor Ron Roberts. Her major opponents so far include Councilman Carl DeMaio, Congressman Bob Filner, and Assemblyman Nathan Fletcher. The San Diego City Council approved an agreement with the San Diego Police Officers Association over health care for retired officers. The POA is the last of the city's six major unions to sign off on the deal. The move means future retirees are taken care of with similar plans, but it does lower the value of benefits.
Modern technology is playing a big role in erasing some of the stigma associated with traditional autism therapy. NBC 7 San Diego's Alicia Dean is here to explain. Alicia.
Hey there, Catherine. Giving people with autism a fair shot at living a full productive life in the community. Guess what? Believe it or not, there's an app for that.
Where we have pads, iPads, tablets, and so forth, that for which there are hundreds of apps now that help people learn, help us get creative when we're working with them. You can easily take a picture of somebody trying to say a word and then send that home with them so mom can know what it is that he's trying to learn to say.
Parents and educators from all over the Southwest will spend the next 3 days sharing ideas and hearing from a wide range of experts on the latest methods and technologies for treating autism patients at the Summer Autism Conference that's being held at the University of San Diego. Now, here's a cool thing. App developers from Apple will also be at this conference to help educators and counselors develop custom teaching tools. The overall goal of the conference is to make treatment of autism more mainstream and to foster a better understanding of those who have the disability.
People with autism, people with developmental disabilities are a gift. And if we look at people's giftedness rather than what their deficits are or what other people have considered their deficits to be, we'd be a much richer nation, a much richer world.
And the conference will also have sessions on using song and dance as a tool to help students with autism find acceptance in mainstream classrooms and how to use yoga and other relaxation methods to treat the disability. The conference runs through Wednesday. Alicia Dean, NBC 7, San Diego.
Alicia Dean, thanks very much. A new state law takes effect on Friday requiring carbon monoxide detectors in all homes.
They're pretty simple to install. They actually have batteries that will operate. They actually have a plug-in type that you can put into a regular receptacle, or they have what they call a combination smoke CO detector.
Previous laws only required newly constructed homes to have CO alarms. Carbon monoxide is odorless, colorless, and lighter than air. People who are poisoned by it experience flu-like symptoms and nausea. County firefighters say poisonings can happen in any home with an attached garage or with fossil fuel as a source, as one woman found out when she noticed a repairman did not properly attach her alarm to the ceiling.
I immediately popped it back in and it went ballistic. Okay, so I'm a mom, I have a bunch of kids upstairs, I have a babysitter, I have a husband. I call the gas company and they literally said, we're shutting down your hot water heater, it's 30 below, go sleep somewhere else, because if anyone were in this basement right now, they would be dead.
Firefighters recommend you replace your smoke detectors with the combination smoke detector carbon monoxide unit. The new law will go into effect for condos and townhomes in July of 2013.
Well, 8 months after a shooting at a local elementary school, the Carlsbad Unified School District plans to spend nearly $600,000 to upgrade fences at 8 of its schools. According to our media partner, the North County Times, district officials say the new fences will make the school safer and create a more closed campus. In October, a man jumped a fence and opened fire on students at Kelly Elementary School. Two girls were shot in the arm. They have since recovered.
A town in San Diego was taken over by fifth graders today as part of a learning experience. It's called BizTown. The 10,000 square foot mini city allows kids to discover how free enterprise really works. There were 21 life-size shops, including a nonprofit organization, a city hall, and an NBC 7 San Diego News Studio. Some of our own news team and staff were on hand to help out the students. The students prepared for today by interviewing for jobs and learning how to balance a checkbook. Even the mayor had to research how to do a good job.
Being able to be friendly, responsible, have to keep up with work, like things just to be in order and be responsible.
Do you want to be mayor when you grow up?
I think it's a hard job, but yes.
Mayor Matthews sounds good too. Organizers say these hands-on activities help students understand their economic world. It also prepares them for academic learning and lifelong achievement to boot.
It's pretty cool. We are going to talk when we come back about homeschooling. You might know somebody that homeschools their kids. I know a couple of folks we work with here do. For a lot of people, it really is the right choice, and more people are doing it. Not everybody, though, says it works for them. So we'll look at that when we come back.
This is Last Night in the San Diego music scene.
I can't show you that one.
San Diego, only at NBCSanDiego.com.
We salute you, weekend warrior. From useless wasteland to Party Central. We knew you had it in you. Take control, get it done. RCP, Block and Brick, your outdoor living headquarters. Oh yeah.
She's always been there for you.
She's made you laugh. She's made you cry. She's interviewed some of the most famous people in the world. And she's not going anywhere.
Hello!
Whew, how does she do that?
As a San Diegan and the daughter of a breast cancer survivor, I feel especially connected to our community. My calling? I found it right here at home.
Hey, eat breast cancer!
When you work together on something meaningful, you enrich your own life in the process.
You folks are saving lives today. Thank you.
Giving back is never a one-way street.
I used to be homeless.
Hopeless.
I was workless.
Loveless.
I was less.
Now I have shelter.
Now I have a home.
I have hope.
Now I am not less.
I am more.
I am more.
I am more.
Well, it looks like more people are homeschooling their kids. An estimate from the group called the National Home Education Research Institute found that about 2 million kids were homeschooled last year. And whether it's for reasons because maybe they're being bullied or they're getting not so great test scores, homeschooling is providing a real alternative for parents who have those concerns. NBC's Nora O'Donnell takes a closer look at the growing trend to see why it's working for some people, maybe not the right option for everybody.
Eight-year-old Zion and her six-year-old sister Selah are learning all about Europe.
France and Finland?
But they have never stepped foot in a classroom. Instead, their mother homeschools them. Why?
It's just numerically impossible for a teacher to give the needed attention to every student. And you have a concern of whether or not your child is going to slip through the cracks.
It's a growing trend, says the National Home Education Research Institute, which estimates about 2 million students were homeschooled last year. The appeal, some experts say, in part is parental control.
There are a lot of people who are now homeschooling because they're just not happy with the quality of education they're either getting in the public schools or in the private schools that are around them.
But others, like the National Education Association, believe that homeschooling cannot provide a student with a comprehensive educational experience. The NEA's recommendations for homeschooling include students be limited to immediate family, pass tests to ensure academic progress, parents should be licensed by a state agency, and curriculums equivalent to state standards. While homeschooling is legal nationwide, some states have stricter requirements than others. Minnesota requires students to take the state's standardized tests, and parents must have teaching certificates or college degrees. Oklahoma simply requires that the students' learning be equivalent to the subjects and hours taught in public school. Jenny Fumarola has tried homeschooling and was concerned about the results.
I don't feel like, as parents, we can always give them the background that they need to keep up with the other kids that are going to school.
Sangria Watkins is committed to homeschooling Selah and Zion.
Nobody loves my children and cares about their well-being more than me, so I'm going to have a higher level of commitment to making sure that they're getting the best education possible.
While bullying, low test scores, and teaching scandals can ravage the nation's school system, homeschooling moves mainstream, an alternative for concerned parents. Nora O'Donnell, NBC News, Washington.
Well, big troubles for one of sports' most storied franchises. The Los Angeles Dodgers today filed for bankruptcy protection. The baseball team owners filed the paperwork in a Delaware court. Frank McCourt is blaming Major League Baseball for not approving a TV deal between the team and Fox Network. McCourt and his wife have been embroiled in a contentious divorce that has added to the team's woes. The bankruptcy filing gives the team short-term cash to stay afloat if a judge approves it tomorrow. Cleanup is underway in Buenos Aires after soccer fans there rioted when their team was busted down to a lower league. River Plate has won Argentina's top soccer championship a record 33 times, but after a poor season, they were relegated to the country's second division. It didn't go over well. Fans went crazy inside stands. It quickly escalated outside. Police used hoses and water cannons and tear gas, all trying to gain control. 25 people in all were injured.
We are going to tell you about this really cool camera that is coming out. Have you heard about it, where you can take a picture and then you focus it later?
If you make a mistake.
I think so. You could even do it on purpose.
Right. Which is great after a night of partying.
The pictures on Facebook are going to get a lot clearer.
Right.
We'll be right back.
Talk right after.
It's a case of inner space, chemically dependent, through the veins to the brain, a whole solar system, and I'm a jet set.
Yeah, so we don't look like this.
I'm an alchemist.
But like this.
I mix the ocean up with thoughts and the outcomes bliss. Inner vision ain't my boss, without a doubt, take risks. The price of progress, what that costs. I'll dish out them chips. A chip batter like a sculptor carved out a wish. I'm on a chemical romance, and life is a trip. A slow dance.
You see them every day, filling their time with empty tasks and outmoded displays of masculinity.
They're adult men, and each one is precious.
Fortunately, there's help.
Right now, there's boys like me ready to be matched.
Just waiting to share our wisdom and friendship as little brothers. If you're a man, please contact Big Brothers Big Sisters. It's not too late to help you.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. If you or a loved one was diagnosed with mesothelioma, call the number on your screen now. Mesothelioma and other asbestos-related diseases such as lung cancer have been directly linked to asbestos exposure. Exposure to asbestos in mills, shipyards, or in the heating, automotive, and construction industries may have put you at risk. If you or a loved one was diagnosed with mesothelioma, call the number on your screen now for a free legal consultation. Secondhand exposure to asbestos may have also put loved ones at risk for mesothelioma or lung cancer. If you've been diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer, please don't wait. Call today for your free legal consultation. You may be entitled to compensation. We're standing by to take your call in confidence.
Call 1-800-335-1065. Don't delay. That's 1-800-335-1065.
From now on, if you want a trip to Australia, you're going to have to ask Auntie Ellen.
Weekdays at 3 on NBC.
Well, as we've been talking about, everything that we have known about taking photographs could be about to change.
There's a new camera that's on the way that will allow you to adjust the focus of a photograph after you've taken a picture.
Scott Budman visited the Silicon Valley company that is making it.
If we click here to discover what he's showing us, it's his daughter in their backyard taking a moment to smell the flowers.
It's technology that will change the way you take and look at pictures.
It's the king.
Silicon Valley-based Lytro, using both hardware and software to let you interact with photographs in a new way. Unhappy with the focus? Change it long after you've taken the shot. It's amazing what can be hidden inside a photograph until you look at it in a different way.
Humans just have a fundamental need to capture our memories and share them visually. That's what we're trying to do, share our visual stories. So it's not just for the photographer, but really for the people that we want to share it with.
Coincidentally, we visited Lytro founder Ren Ung back in 2008 when he was working on what's called light field technology at Stanford. Now he's got a startup with photos you can embed into your Facebook page or even move around on your iPhone. The actual light field camera will be released later.
But really using advanced technology to make simpler, faster, more magical cameras, that's really what we're trying to do.
It is advanced, out of the lab, and ready for you to play with.
Well, the camera's going to be introduced and sold later this year.
A fast food restaurant is offering up a new high-tech soda dispenser. A Burger King in the Sacramento area has a small dispenser developed by Coca-Cola that offers a big selection. Drink it your way, 125 flavors. The screen guides you through the unusual flavors of sodas and waters and energy drinks and all that. Inside is a cartridge of concentrated liquid flavors. Look at all those choices. And a computer which orders and tracks the flavor preferences. Customers seem to like it.
I didn't know that they had like all these different bulk combinations, so I was just pressed. I just put them all into one cup and then tried it out.
We've had people taking pictures of it. One girl came in and hugged it. So it's really? Been a really good reaction. Yeah.
The machine is actually an outgrowth of medical technology. Similar systems were used to analyze and dispense precise amounts of chemotherapy for cancer patients. Now it is being fashioned for soft drink consumption. Mm.
Okay, so how would you like high fashion showing up on your doorstep every single month?
It's a modern version of the Book of the Month Club, but instead of hardbound books, you're getting sequins and stilettos. The first of every month, at midnight, possibly thousands of women are waiting by their computers.
They want to see what shoes have been selected for them. NBC 7 San Diego's consumer Bob says it's a shopping trend that's sweeping the country.
I am definitely a little obsessed with shoes. I'm definitely a shoeaholic, if you will.
And to satisfy Claudia Sandoval's shoe craving, this San Diego native signed up for Shoe Dazzle, an online shoe company that offers a monthly surprise for each of its customers for $39.95, including shipping.
Every time that I get a package, it's like, oh my gosh, I can't wait to open my... It's like a gift to yourself, almost.
They answer a bunch of questions telling us about their style, their preferences, what brands they affiliate with, which celebrity style that they like.
Sexy, but demure.
And Shoe Dazzle's Deborah Benton says they create a customer profile, linking your survey answers to a particular look or style. Then every month, members go online to view five different shoes selected for them.
We have from, an aggressive fashion-forward Rihanna, for example, to, a little more sophisticated, imagine a Reese Witherspoon, and we run the full spectrum.
Talking about August and key trends. Bridget,
the actual shoes are designed at the Santa Monica office. They're manufactured in Asia and mailed to customers across the U.S. and Canada.
Great color blocking going on, which is a huge trend.
The shoes are all man-made synthetics, no real leather. Kim Kardashian and Robert Shapiro are the biggest names behind the company, and it seems to be taking off.
These are actually my going out heels, like my go-to heel.
Claudia says she buys from one of her monthly picks about six times a year and prefers shoes on the flashier side. She got this pair in the mail a couple days ago.
Because they are so enclosed, your foot feels real secure.
The color blocking is still really hot, as is the cutout, so you can see some sexy part of the foot.
The idea is to take the upscale Rodeo Drive sort of high fashion and package it into a more affordable shoe. Besides high heels, there are wedges, flats, even boots.
We really come out with killer lines every month.
And success is spawning competing Shoe of the Month Club websites, a business model bringing together penny-pinching fashionistas and customers who find new shoes not only convenient, but a downright necessity.
My friends call me crazy sometimes for it, but...
Okay, so here's how it works. Shoe Dazzle will charge your account $39.95 every month unless you choose to opt out. You have 5 days to do that when the new designs come out.
It seems like a lot of fun. Bob, however, being the shoe expert, wanted to point out that there are other places you can look for shoes at a bargain. DSW has a lot of good ones. Yeah. Payless, Nordstrom's Rack, that's a good one. And there's also a lot of online sites that have those brand names without, you know, having to commit to some sort of monthly thing.
But that fee's not a lot.
It's
for shoes?
No, not if you add up what you can spend if you just go get one pair at a normal store.
Right, exactly. Sign back with more right after this.
Can you read my number?
Attention those on Medicare with diabetes. You may be eligible for an upgraded meter.
I am tired of stabbing my fingertips to test my blood glucose. There has got to be a better way.
If you're on Medicare with diabetes, then you need to know there's a new method for checking your blood glucose. You don't need to stab your fingertips anymore. This new Embrace meter is easier to use and nearly painless. And the best news? Is that Diabetes Care Club will send you one of these new meters.
This new method hurts less, and I don't have to stab my fingertips anymore.
Not only can I see my number, I can hear it too.
Your blood glucose reading is 89.
There's my number.
Find out why nearly a quarter of a million patients have joined Diabetes Care Club.
Call Diabetes Care Club.
Shipping is free, and so is the call.
Call 1-800-934-1557. Call now.
I'm glad I did.
I'm an 11-time national kite champion.
I'm a third-generation Italian-American.
I'm lowering your ears.
I'm up with the early birds.
I'm your local bike shop.
I'm a topiary artist.
I'm an outdoors guy.
I'm just stretching my sea legs.
I'm helping you get there in style.
You gotta love this view of San Diego.
We are San Diego.
We are San Diego.
We are San Diego.
We are San Diego.
As a San Diegan and the daughter of a breast cancer survivor, I feel especially connected to our community. My calling? I found it right here at home. When you work together on something meaningful, you enrich your own life in the process.
You folks are saving lives today. Thank you.
Giving back is never a one-way street.
Okay, check out this video. If you look closely, you can see a 4-foot spinner shark jump out of the water and sail over a surfer in Florida. See that?
That's crazy.
A photographer with the Orlando Sentinel caught it on camera. Let's see if we see it again.
There.
Look at that. But he didn't even know he had it on tape actually until he was back editing the video.
Otherwise, he would have screamed really loud, watch it!
I know, right?
That's kind of crazy.
Isn't that crazy?
Do you remember that jacket that Michael Jackson wore, that red and black one in the Thriller video? Of course you do.
When his eyes were all crazy.
There it is. Oh, look at that. It's in nice shape. And it sold.
$1.8 million?
Yes, look at that. $1.8 million. They put it up for auction, and they sold it for a lot of money. This is the scene where he wore it and where he's dancing with the zombies. This was like before Plants and Zombies, so he really was the first one to bring out the zombie craze. The person who bought it, who spent that much money, you want to know, probably was a commodities trader from Austin. And the cool thing is that he says he's going to send it out on tour, but then use the money that it's raised, that's raised by this tour for children's charities. And it has been, this past Saturday was 2 years ago that Michael Jackson died. Mm. That's a
classic
video.
That was some video. I know.
Yes, it was.
All right. Look who came to these stands. Prince William and his new wife, Kate, spent the afternoon at Wimbledon. They were led to their seats by tennis great Billie Jean King. The royal couple watched fellow countryman Andy Murray from the Royal Box and Center Court. Buckingham Palace says Kate has been to Wimbledon many times and she's a big tennis fan. They weren't disappointed today. Murray defeated his rival to reach the quarterfinals.
She always looks good, Kate. It's a cute outfit. Okay, so this is one, sorry.
What?
It's one of NBC's biggest hits of all time.
And she probably has shoe dazzle too coming to her.
I bet you she does.
Coming to the palace every month. The Voice, by the way, is coming down to the wire.
The gold days of love. Can you hear the sound?
That is Vicky Martinez. She is one of four finalists. Tomorrow night at 9 p.m., they will all perform, hoping that you will choose them as the winner of a $100,000 prize and a recording contract. You can imagine they're a little bit nervous.
Yeah, we all get that. I mean, I think I could speak definitely for everyone here that when they say 2 minutes till you're on live, that's like freak out time.
Yeah.
What?
That's totally. What I,
The 2 hour show airs tomorrow at 9, and then Wednesday night, the winner will be revealed.
That does it for us. Thanks very much for watching.
See you tomorrow.
Looking for a quick, affordable way to transform your entire home? It's easy to dramatically change your style with new flooring from America's Finest Carpet Company. Enjoy super summer savings on beautiful and durable Stainmaster carpeting, only 99 cents a square foot, or stylish Berber, only 89 cents a square foot. Great selection, professional service, and always a fair price. America's Finest Carpet Company. Call our toll-free number at 888-402-AFCC.